Hello there. Welcome to you. Hope everybody's doing great. Welcome to Wednesday. Let's see what's going on. This is Daily Tarot for you. Just take whatever resonates and leave what doesn't, okay? So some things might be for you, some things might not be for you. Sometimes lessons come through, teaching comes through. This week, today, on our heart healing group, we're going to be talking about triggers. How to deal with them, how to understand what they mean, and how to move through them, okay, for your best and highest good. So that is on our heart healing group today at 3:30. If you're not in, jump on. There's a link in the description box below. All right, let's see where we're going today. What is going on for you? The guides are assembled. Wow, this card keeps showing up. Jealousy. Time and veiled. I feel like there's somebody watching you who has been for some time. I feel like they are frenemy. I feel like they're jealous of what you've accomplished. I feel like they're super low vibe. And the worst part is I think they think they're kind of awesome. I think they think they're amazing. And you do, as an empath, do get the truth, which eventually will be open to everybody. Anybody who's conscious, anybody who's living a conscious life, gets the energy of someone who's a frenemy versus someone who is legit, right? And a lot of us who've had really toxic relationships our whole life, that kind of picker is broken, right? Like we can kind of... it feels familiar, so we go toward it, even though somewhere in your intuition is saying, hey, red flag, this is a red flag. And what you're learning to do living consciously is bringing in that sense of not only elevating that information a little bit stronger to you, like overcoming that people-pleasing desire, overcoming that need to, you know, someone's being... wow, someone's being sparkly with me, so that must mean they're a good person or something like that. It's overcoming that paradigm that you have, right? It's about changing that paradigm around. So we're not overriding our own intuition, okay? So there's definitely some jealousy being leveled at you, especially if you're living a conscious life, if you've had any kind of success at all. And if you haven't, and you feel like you're not getting anywhere or you're, you know, comparing yourself to other people, that's the energy we need to move you out of, because there's absolutely nothing good that happens. But here's the thing, happens to the best of us. So forgive yourself for it, okay? Don't go like, oh God, I'm not living a conscious life, I'm not awake. Please don't do that to yourself, because it's not helpful. And you're human, okay? You're human. Sorry to break the news. But the fact is that other people prey on that wobbly sense of self-awareness, that wobbly sense of a self-esteem. And so that's why we're doing all this work on this channel about awakening and understanding your own power and how to kind of become a spiritual warrior. Because I feel like there's people around who right now who might be trying to mess with you a little bit, okay? So just know that that's possibility. All right, I'll address the time one in a second. I was talking with someone who had sent, well, I was emailing back and forth with someone who was asking about 3D, 4D, 5D, and 4D is really the element of time, and how you can shift the paradigm for yourself about time. So you know how it feels when time goes really fast, right? Like you're doing something you really love, or you're with people who are really amazing, or summertime or something, like whatever it is that feels good to you can kind of move fast. And things that don't feel good to you can stick around forever. So we're talking about working with that time in element in the 4D. And the 5D is where you just see nothing as duality, nothing is good or bad. It's just things that happen. So what you're doing is you're removing yourself from making a judgment call that something's bad and, oh my God, I get afraid because I'm going to get more of it and, oh my God, right? Like, okay, just chill. The key to this, to unhooking yourself from the paradigm of don't want versus want, right? That's 3D, very, very dualistic. 3D is everything is, you know, there's bad or good. There's dark or night, dark or light. There's sweet or sour. There's just duality. And in the 5D, there's not duality. It's just flow. It's flow state. And I'm going to give you, that's what we're going to do in the Heart Healing Group. I'm going to give you some exercises to help you stop yourself from just jumping into reactive mode and instead be in conscious mode, right? Be constantly conscious. Just have this element of peace about you. And that's what meditation does for you. But not everybody has been doing that. So we're going to give you, I'm going to give you an easy exercise, okay, in the Heart Healing Group. Okay, so on to tarot. Six of Cups underneath, the Five of Cups, the High Priestess, Seven of Cups. Wow, lots of Cancer energy here. Moving forward, the Chariot energy, the Temperance energy. Wow, the nine of Cups. All right, this is interesting. Five of Pentacles and the Knight of Swords. What we're doing is we're kind of getting rid of a cycle here. So there's a couple of messages coming through this little reading underneath. What the cards that are underneath are things that you don't see coming, things that are subconscious, things that are kind of behind the veil. And I feel like some of you are really aware of somebody that you're leaving behind that might fit this bill of being jealous or something like that. But there's definitely jealousy around you coming from a past relationship, a lifelong relationship or something. I feel like you're just letting it go. And that does feel sad, right? It feels sad. It's like, oh, now I see this person. You know, I was confused for a while, but now I'm picking a new path. Now I'm picking a new path. I'm going forward. I'm being embraced by Archangel Michael. I'm moving forward on my path. And then, you know, I get what I want. And then all of a sudden, like my anxiety kicks in and I go, ah, oh no, I don't deserve this. Okay. So there's a sense of self-worthiness, an inability to receive the good things that come your way. So even if you get to that point of like success, does it all collapse on you, right? Like, you know, hey, happens to the best of us. And so we're working on moving through this because I feel like every time something does move forward, you get to a dizzying height of success or you get to this one level and then you fall back down, right? Like you can't seem to push through that level. And so that's what we're going to be working on. And really it's about you seeing and stopping the reactive mode of falling into fear or anxiety when things get too good, when's the other shoe going to drop, right? It's really important that you stop that reaction and instead respond. Stop the reacting, like, oh God, I got an extra bill. Oh my God, like freaking out. Like we really have to put a stop because what happens is you cycle down into these emotions and it takes a while to get you out. Okay. It takes a while to stop it. It takes a while. So we have to replace that with a general acceptance of whatever comes across your path is flow. It's not good or bad. Just is. And so part of that work is understanding your own mission and purpose, understanding your own, I can do it kind of thing. This is why affirmations, need to make you some affirmations. This is why affirmations are so powerful. You got this kind of a thing. All right. I posted something on the community page yesterday morning. One of my favorite sayings, never forget how wildly successful you are. Never forget how wildly competent you are. Never forget how wildly good at stuff you are. Never forget. Never forget. And it does feel to me that it's easy to forget that. It's easy to not believe it, especially if you've had many, many years of not believing it. Never forget how wildly capable you are. And that's where we're going today. There's the Judgment card, Eight of Pentacles, the Lovers, Page of Wands, Nine of Swords, Hanged Man, Four of Cups, Eight of Swords, really stuck in your head here, but you're overcoming this. You're surrendering to this new way of being, which is non-dualistic, which is 5D, which is just about flow state. And I feel like some of you have this really, like working hard. And when things happen, you're like, well, what's the point of working hard? Things still happen. And so that's the point of flow state. That's the point of not reacting all the time, because reacting is sort of like your brain sort of sees everything as a threat, or sees things that cause you anxiety as a threat. So it's like fight or flight. It gets you going. It gets this energy moving. And it's like, I've seen hundreds of comments on this very channel about people saying, what's the point? What's the point? All this work on the self, I'm sick of it. Stuff like that. Which basically is, in my view, like a cry for help. That someone's saying, I've worked really hard and all I'm getting is this shit sandwich. But if you're looking at it like that, then of course it's going to be worse. So no matter, you know, we're on this planet to learn and to go through cycles. And so if you're in that energy of, I hate that, you're putting emotion behind that thought about that particular thing. And so it's going to keep showing up. It's going to keep showing up because the universe doesn't care. There's no duality, right? Fear, love, all of it, it's full on emotion. So whatever you give full on emotion to is going to come back to you. So it's not just about like, oh, I have to flow love towards something that I have hated all these years. There's a sense of like a non-dualistic approach to this. Like we don't do that shtick. We don't be like, because it's super unauthentic. Oh, I love that extra $5,000 bill I got for my son's healthcare. Oh, I love that. No, you don't. No, you don't. Okay. So knock it off. What you're doing is you're not reacting because you're seeing everything as flow. There's no bad or good. It's just flow. It's just things float across. If you are triggered by a certain thing, there's a lot of people who aren't triggered at all. So it's not inherently bad. It's not inherently bad. Even if you're not somebody who has like millions in the bank, but you get an extra bill, but you're like, I can handle this. I've done it before. I can handle this. I know I can. Not a big deal. All right. What do I need to do? All right, Spirit, please bring some help. Okay, Spirit, bring me an opportunity that's going to help me pay for this or something like that. Like if you slam it in a drawer and try to forget about it and stick your head in the sand and go out with your friends and spend a lot of money on shoes and you have even less money, like all of those things are escapist. And what's trying to happen here is like, hey, you know, on the surface of it, I'm working really hard. Like, can't you see how hard I'm working? Can't you see, Spirit? This is, you know, Archangel Gabriel waking you up. Can't you see? Can't you see? And then in the middle of the night, there's an authenticity check. Okay, anxiety shows up in the middle of the night. Even when we're in our best during the day, sometimes our night times are terrifying. It's because we're stuck in paradigms that keep us in the place of, I don't know how I'm going to do this. I'm going to get, it's death, right? Threatening, it's death. And so it keeps us in this four of cups mode. It keeps us from moving forward. Keeps all that good stuff from happening until we go through a bad cycle, right? I was talking the other day about nature needs a balance. And so there's cycles to everything on this planet. You have control of how you respond. And the more you respond in a neutral way, the more you keep yourself in peaceful mode, the less bad stuff, if you call it bad, the less stuff that you don't want is attracted. It's like it's no fun anymore to come toward you. It doesn't get any response. there are people on this planet. We talked a lot about narcissists on this channel. We talk a lot about narcissistic partners, toxic partners, plutonic relationships, and Pluto. Pluto, okay, Pluto in their chart, pinging you madly. Those people who are in that energy don't care if they get love from you or they get hate from you. In many ways, they are non-dualistic. That blow your mind? In many ways, attention is attention. They just want attention for a very negative reason. It's all about them. Me, myself, and I. Me, 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 I. They don't care if they get positive or negative attention. They just want attention. So they'll take it any way they can. If they have to manipulate you, they will. They will. So your job is not to be in that lower vibration of just gimme, 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 super low vibration. To be at peace is to not sort of ruffle the feathers of anything that's really craggy or really difficult. To be at peace. And joy is not far behind, because boy, peace is lovely. So when you give something negative attention, when you get, it's just emotion, right? It's just energy. Your job is to be at peace, okay? Whatever comes across the transom, don't react, respond. So we'll be talking about that today. But that's what the goal is, really, in handling life in a way that's more even, that's more moving you into a higher state, into 4D, into 5D. Once you get into 5D, which is non-dualistic, which is neither good nor bad, things just are, and there's just a sense of flow to it. Boy, when you go back into 3D, it's pretty challenging to do that if you're living life in that 5D, but you can. It just feels really super bad. So once you've been up in that 5D, I don't even want to call it up because I don't want to give you the sense that there's any hierarchy here, because there's reasons for all the dimensions. There's reasons for it. And this feels to me like where we are right now is I'm working so hard and I'm still in this Nine of Swords and Eight of Swords kind of mentality and these in these mindsets. So it's almost like you get a good idea and you're moving forward and everything's good. And then you get anxiety and then you collapse into these old mindsets again. So this is really about your decision to surrender to peace. Surrender to peace. Okay, I don't even care why this is going on. I have 7, 8, 9 of swords. Don't want to know. Don't want to go into that. But it's your choice to move forward here. 4 of pentacles, 2 of pentacles, fool. And the 3 of swords here. 6 of swords, moving on from that, king of cups. So what I'm seeing here is this up and down. Okay, right? This up and down. 4 of pentacles. 4 of cups, holding on for dear life. Instead of seeing it as like, oh, wow, I've got 4 of pentacles, right? The 2 of pentacles guy has half. But he's like, look at this. I got a bunch of choices. Instead of this guy who's like, don't touch me. Don't touch me. All right. So there's just an openness to this 2 of pentacles in this deck. There's a lot going on around this person, but they still have choices. This person makes themselves stop. Okay. Because they're worried about choosing the wrong thing, or it's definitely in the mindset that this is going on. So as a fool, we are taking a leap of faith. We have multiple choices. We have lots of things going on. And we're not going to sort of sit in that energy of 3 of swords. Are we leaving behind people because we're choosing a different way of life? You bet we are. King of Cups here is the energy of feminine and masculine integrated. We're walking away from old habits around in our mindset. All right. We're walking away from that. We're deciding. To surrender to flow, to surrender to peace. And this jealousy piece, Three of Pentacles, Six of Pentacles, Magician, Ten of Cups. I just feel like you have it going on, okay? And even if you don't right now, you will. Because there's a reason we're getting that energy. Some of you have been up and down this roller coaster a bunch of times. Some of you have had some success and then had it collapse on them. Some of you have been in these places where you're not sure what the next path is. We've been talking about that for about a week or two now. And we're getting closer to that Pisces full moon when we're releasing any of these dualistic kind of patterns. We're releasing anything to spirit. We're starting to learn to work with spirit, to ask for help with spirit. Three of Pentacles and Six of Pentacles. To ask for help, to get us to this sort of flow state, to this peaceful state, so we can manifest the things we truly want. And let it go. And just move on with our day. All right? But putting into place some kind of expression or experience that's going to get us out of this stuck mindset. So I'm going to keep going on. I'm going to pull a card for each zodiac sign just to give you a little more guidance, okay? So the link is below if you want to continue on with me. This is definitely about building a kind of new life. That this cycle is going to be different. All right. Link is below if you want to continue on. Let's keep going, Pathfinders. All right. I hope you enjoyed that video. If it was helpful to you, please consider liking this video and sharing it with anybody who might have a need for similar kind of information. And if you like this video, check out these videos.